Good morning. This is January 22nd, 2012. Today could be an interesting day. There is an organization, a worldwide organization, called the Military and Hospitallier Order of the St. Lazarus of Jerusalem. It's an order that goes back to the First Crusade. began doing charitable work with a primary focus on leprosy in those days. The organization still exists, and still one of their primary works has to do with leprosy, although, okay, ordinarily this award would be presented at a ceremony, but with the COVID epidemic going on, they'd cancel all such gatherings. So this year they're restarting such gatherings, and they will be formally presenting the award this morning. So here's a paper. Here's the medal. So this is being presented to three people this afternoon, this morning, that I know of. Myself, Stuart Ching, who is the archivist for the Fathers of the Sacred Heart United States Province. That's the religious order that Father Damien belonged to. And of course, Damien's work was with the leprosy patients on Molokai. The third person that's receiving the award is Father Bill Petrie, also a Sacred Hearts father, who worked with Mother Teresa for many, many years. So let's get ready to go down to St. Augustine Church in Waikiki and see how the ceremony goes. There's a two-part ceremony, apparently. From 8:30 to 9:30 is a vigil, and from 9:30 to 10:30 is the investiture, whatever that is.
Here is Stephen Yields. That is my our friend Apollonia, and that is Pat. We're going to the church where the ceremony will be held. First step, restroom. Look at these plants. I have this one. Look at the entrance of this church and the building close to it. The Filipinos there.
No, it does matter this time. Because we got a little way you do it when we bring people up. So you will be in the first pew and they can sit a couple of pews back.
Okay.
We have a professional video.
The area is blocked, so we cannot go there.
In the 3rd century AD, Christians made pilgrimages to the Holy Land. Many of these pilgrims became infected with Francis' disease and needed care. Various facilities for their needs were established, usually outside the walls of the Holy City. Already by the 6th century, built a church in the very stand section of Jerusalem near the church of the Holy Sepulchre dedicated to St. John and associated with a large hospice for the care of the sick. With the taking of Jerusalem on July 14, 1098, by Crusader forces, the religious communities at St. John's and other sites increased, and the hospital back to the foundation on this date, even though the order is
in days gone by, we did not of our place spend the night in prayer before the altar. In remembrance for their splendid example, we have gathered.
From the 28th letter of St. Damian, dated November 9th, 1887. Unfortunately, Almighty God has not yet told me of this.
From the letter of St. Damian to Father Leonardo, dated June 1883. I am to sacrifice themselves for the salvation of the souls of the poor islanders. I am not afraid of it, even to minister to the abandoned lepers.
What follows the sleep of the faith of Christ.
Mr. Elroy, Maquia Malo.
dear brothers and sisters, through the gospel history, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. Let us now renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promise to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death, rose again from the dead and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus.
One for each point of the Maltese cross. The first beatitude. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. The purity of my spirit will help me to seek for that spirit within me. That spirit is God, and in seeking God, I will seek God's kingdom.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, strengthen me with your Holy Spirit, so that I may be resolved to seek your will in all things.
Amen.
The second beatitude. Blessed are they who mourn, for they shall be comforted. To mourn is to realize our own mortality and limitations. In mourning, recognize our weakness and our frailty. In mourning, we reach out beyond ourselves in complete dependence on the Lord. The gospel reminds us that in putting our trust in the Lord and accepting our vulnerability, God will comfort us.
Let us pray. Take it, God.
Demands that our Christian calling is to seek the goodness of God in all things.
bless this sword of state, which will be used to invest postulates into the order of St. Lazarus. May all who are invested with this sword remember to be living disciples of your Son, following the examples of Saints David and Marianne, who cared for the outcast and marginalized in society. We ask all this through Christ, our Redeemer and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Almighty God, we ask your blessing upon these symbols of our order. May they be true signs for our spiritual unity through our common baptism in Jesus Christ our Savior. All this we ask in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Hear, O Lord, our prayers, and deign through the power of your majesty to bless these insignia and vesture of office, and protect those your servants who desire to wear them, so that they may be strong to guard, defend, and spread the Christian faith. We ask this through Christ.
Amen.
Almighty and providential God, who gave us St. Damian and St. Marianne as examples of Christian discipleship, bless these pilgrim shells which will be worn by those who have made pilgrimage to call upon. May the bearers of these shells emulate the merciful love of your Son in serving those in need. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God.
would normally process out of the chapel in a turn. Today, the solemn vestures will follow immediately after a brief interlude.
In the name of God the Father, the Son, help of God, we choose these brethren to be admitted into the ranks of our holy and venerable order of St. Lazarus.
Thanks be to God.
You have prayed that you may be admitted to this ancient and noble order. We have been assured that you are such persons as may be fitly so admitted, but that we may be certain of your full understanding of what you propose to do, and of your acceptance of the high aims and ideals of our order, and that you are devoutly intending to live henceforth for these aims and ideals, and further that we may judge the sincerity and earnestness of your desire to enter the ancient and honorable ranks of children, our required charge that publicly and openly, before God and this congregation, now assembled, solemn and serious answer to the following question.
Postulants, do you solemnly promise to observe and obey the statutes and ordinances of the military and hospitality order of St. Lazarus of Jerusalem, to uphold in your life and conversations high ideals of Christian devotion, service, and charity, to further by your labor, oblations, and prayers, its efforts to alleviate suffering, to succor Christians in endangered lands, and to bring about that blessed unity of all Christian people which truly belongs to Christ's holy Catholic Church.
Amen.
Do you solemnly promise to give all due obedience, loyalty, and respect to the presiding officer of the order and to the grand prior of the nation, and to hold in all reverence all who are set in authority in the order, saving always that right and proper allegiance, loyalty, obedience, and respect which you hold to the United States of America?
I do.
Do you solemnly promise to hold fast the Christian faith, to collaborate in all good works and enterprises of this order, and to employ all your influence and effort for the preservation, growth, and splendor of the order?
I do.
As God, by his grace, has given you the will to do to perform these things, may he, by his mercy, grant you strength and power, faithfully to fulfill his things.
Most Reverend Parents, Father Silva, Senior Chaplain,
in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and by the authority committed to me, I do now create, make, and confirm you a senior chaplain of this most noble military and hospitaller order of St. Lazarus of Jerusalem. Arise, Bishop Larry, and congratulations. St. Lazarus of Jerusalem. Arise, Anthony, and congratulations.
Mr. Gary M. Garo, OLJ.
Mr. Gary M. Garrow, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and by the authority committed to me, I do now create, make, and confirm you an officer of this most noble military and hospitaller order of St. Lazarus of Jerusalem. Arise and congratulations. Reverend Mr. Dario Rinaldi, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and by the authority committed to me, I do now create, make, and confirm you an assistant chaplain of this most noble military and hospitaller order of St. Lazarus of Jerusalem. Congratulations and welcome.
Mr. Augustus, not going. Order St. Lazarus.
Augustus, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, by the authority committed to me, I do now create, make, and confirm you an officer of this most noble military and hospital order at St. Lazarus of Jerusalem. All right, congratulations.
The Very Reverend Kevin Paul Faust, Associate Chaplain of the Order.
Father Kevin, in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, by the authority given, I do now create, make, and confirm you an assistant chaplain for the most noble military and hospital order of St. Lazarus of Jerusalem. Congratulations.
Mr. Robert Hansfield, Order of St. Lazarus. At this time, certain members of the order will be promoted in rank, recognizing for meritorious service to the order and recognized for charitable contribution to the order. The marshal shall escort the awardees in order. For special meritorious recognition, we recognize St. Damien de Bestowed, Order of the Sacred Heart, KMLJ, received by the Reverend Bill Petrie.
It is a distinct privilege of the military and hospitaller order of St. Lazarus of Jerusalem for acknowledging the humanity and the contribution.
Saint Father Damien de Lister, SSCC, by recognizing him with the rank of Knight of Companion Merit of the Order of Saint Lazarus. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and by the authority committed to me, I do now create, make, and confirm Saint Father Damien a Knight of the Companionate of Merit of this most noble military and hospitality order of Saint Lazarus of Jerusalem.
Saint Mary Ann Pope, OSF, PMLJ, received by Sister Williams Marie Eleniki, OSF.
It is my honor to present the meritorious award of the right of faith and the Saint Mary Ann Pope for the dedication and recognition. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, by the authority given to me, I do now create, make, and confirm you, Companion American rank of day, the most noble military hospital of order, St. Lazarus of Jerusalem. Thank you.
Candidates for promotion. From the rank of assistant chaplain to chaplain, the Very Reverend Lay Kalani Akiona, SSCC, CHLJ. For promotion, the Very Reverend William Aloha.
Father Peter, in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and by the authority committed to me, I do now create, make, and confirm you a chaplain for the most noble military and hospital order, St. Lazarus Prison. Thank you. Great, thank you for bringing you a bronze medal for the most Bishop Luke. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. By the authority given to me, I denounce grace and confirm you. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and by the authority committed to me, I do now pray, make and confirm you, companion of merit, rank of member, and the most noble military and hospital order of Lazarus. Congratulations.
Thank you. Why do you look like a pervert?